Hey, Pastor Steve Waldron here. William Tyndale, maybe the greatest reformer of all time, the obedience of a Christian man. I've already done a video where I show in here what he thought about Acts 2:38, how he said it's the precious promises, it's the keys, it's the gospel, and that's found all throughout. You can tell, this was back in a day where I used to dog-ear the pages of stuff that I really liked and underline everything and make triangles. And man, I did that all over this book. This is a fantastic book. It was said that Anne Boleyn had this by her bed and gave it to King Henry VIII. And then she lost her head about it. But that's a whole nother thing. But fantastic. He saw that the Bible, it was illegal in England to have the Bible in English. He translated it in English. He had to translate it again because the Catholics burned all 1,500 copies or 8,000 copies or whatever it was. And actually, it was a neat kind of how it worked, because what was happening is the publisher was getting them in and the Catholics would buy them to burn. They'd burn like 900 at the time and stuff. And so then he'd give the money to Tyndale to keep writing. And Tyndale went to Germany, and then he was on a boat and the boat burned down. The boat sank. He lost all his work. So, and he ends up dying. He ends up dying in prison 500 days. He was betrayed by a friend. He'd go and give to the widows and the fatherless twice a week. He was just a very innocent, very godly Christian type man. And so they got him in Vilvoorde Castle. And so his last words, that famous painting, he's like, "Open the King of England's eyes," October 6, 1536. And at the same time, he has no idea, because he's on the continent in what's now Belgium, that the King of England is now saying the Bible is now legal for everybody. He had no idea that he's praying that God was answering his prayer. So, The Obedience of a Christian Man, I could not recommend this book more highly. Now, I just turned to a random page, page 88, Antichrist. This is in the Penguin Classics. And I think I've done videos on the Penguin Classics just as I really like them, because it's very inexpensive ways to get the classics. You do have to be careful about the editing and who's the editor and the translation of many of them, not on this one. David Daniels actually did this, which I can't recommend David Daniel books more highly. He is a meticulous, awesome scholar. I remember reading David Daniel when he talked about how deism was sweeping through England, and how Handel of Handel's Messiah, the writer of Gulliver's Travels, and Alexander Pope, the poet, got together and said, "We're going to use our combined forces of music and writing and poetry and keep deism out of England," which denies the deity of Jesus and all this, and that God doesn't have personal relationship. Butler and these type guys were propagating it, and keep it out of England. He's got a tremendous chapter in one of his books on that, and they did it. They succeeded and kept England Christian. And then Dickens did the same thing about 100 years later. And Dickens, a lot of people miss, like in A Christmas Carol, he is attacking Kantianism, he's attacking Malthusianism. Some of the things Scrooge is saying is really philosophical. And it's amazing. And so, and that, because he wanted the Christmas to become horrible and the child labor laws, and this is awful. You know, when I say child labor laws, this was before the child labor laws. They were just conscripting the debtors' prisons and all this. And so I turn to page 88 and it says Antichrist. Antichrist of another manner hath sent forth his disciples, those false anointed of which Christ warned us before that they should come and show miracles and wonders, even to bring the very elect out of the way, if it were possible. He anointeth them after the manner of the Jews, and showeth them and shoreth them after the manner of the heathen priest which served the idols. He sendeth them forth not with false oil only, but with false names also, for compare their names unto their deeds, and thou shalt find them false. He sendeth them forth as Paul prophesied of them in 2 Thessalonians 2 with lying signs and wonders. And what sign is the anointing? that they be full of the Holy Ghost, compared to the signs of the Holy Ghost which Paul reckoneth, and thou shalt find it a false sign. A bishop must be faultless, the husband of one wife. Nay, saith the Pope, the husband of no wife, but the holder of so many whores as he liketh. God commandeth all degrees if they burn and cannot live chaste to marry. The Pope saith, if thou burn, take a dispensation for a concubine and put her away. So yeah, they thought, as Wesley and they all thought, that the Pope was the Antichrist. Great book. Can't recommend it more highly. Written in the 1520s. Awesome. You got to get it. God bless you. Talk with you later.